model now. And I mean, I'm like, fuck yeah, like, it's making money now. Like, what are you guys doing?
But, like, the closest people in your life are always like, oh, okay, you're going to be on a reality show. Blah, blah, blah. Because they know you, and they know that they can laugh at you.
Yeah, they know like David that. Back home.
And life changes. Jay, going to Survivor, now I know that you had watched the show before.
Yep.
And you were kind of leaving in a difficult time. Your mom was not healthy. That's tough. And you were a runner-up, or you were a
I made it
a standby,
place.
Right?
Oh, yeah. So the first time I went to Survivor, they actually sent us to Cambodia, and I was just waiting the whole time for someone to get sick or injured or whatever.
How lovely.
I know, right? I'm like, I don't want anyone to get sick, but like, please get sick. Like, it's terrible. But they didn't let me play, so I just stayed in Cambodia for a week. And then I don't mind if I get a refill as well.
Yeah, of course.
And so I stayed in Cambodia for a week, and then I went back home, and I was like, damn, like, I missed my shot. I couldn't make it. And then they called me back, and they're like, hey, thank you for coming to the prelims for this. We'll take you to Fiji. So then I ended up going to Fiji, and like, yeah, it sounds so nice and beautiful, but the first two to three days was just straight rain because we had a, I think it was a category 4, what was it called?
Cyclone, in fact.
Yeah, it was a cyclone.
It was the first. It was the first cast in 33 seasons ever that had to evacuate.
Yeah.
An island.
And everyone's like, "Oh, you got to go to a bed. You got to do." And I was like, "No, we went to just literally a concrete floor, and they gave us potato sacks, and they're just like, go to sleep, and they gave you an apple, and a little bowl of rice, and they're like, because we can make rice on the island, we have a bag, but they're like, here's a little bowl of rice, like a handful, and an apple. Enjoy.
And a paper bag. Yeah. Did Donald Trump?
Sounds like church
this
camp.
Show.
No.
Sorry, should I not say that? Whatever. I don't care.
It sounds like my church camp days in high school, Jay.
I have to say, you did very well on the show. Physically, you nailed most all of the challenges.
Yeah.
But I found it interesting watching Survivor because I thought, oh, well, the fit guys are always going to be the winners, and that wasn't the case. You literally get to see people's perseverance and their strength and courage come out. Some of the people I thought were going to be gone in the first couple episodes stayed till like the very end.
I don't want to talk shit on some people, but like,
this is the time.
Please do. They usually keep like the most athletic guy never makes it to the end. So for me to get as far as I got, I feel blessed because they're always coming after the athlete, and they're always coming after the dude that's like on his like game, you know. But socially, you have to be aware of everyone's surroundings. You have to be aware of all kinds of things all the time. And then on top of that, like, you do get to see everyone's personalities and stuff. So when you have real conversations with people on the island, it's like, I have to get rid of you. I have to crush your dream right now. Like, Michaela was my number one ally, and I had to vote her out. And we used to stay up until, like, 3 in the morning. So I was calculating by the moon and the sun, like, crazy. So I don't know what time. But, I used to talk to her about like growing up and like she didn't have a lot of money and all this stuff. And she's like, I want to win this for my family. I was like, I want to win this for my family too. And I had to eliminate her essentially and take away that dream for her and still be okay with it. And then just like live on with that guilt of like, damn, I stripped somebody of their dream and I'm trying to get it for myself.
But you did have all these people on the island with a dream. And I know your conversations with Adam, I mean, both having moms that were unhealthy. I mean, it's like Sophie's Choice. Like, what do you choose? That little turn of events, though, with Michaela was quite interesting. Kurt, can we take a look? this was the first time that I saw you. I was like, oh, this is how he's going to play the game. Because you were quiet.
I had to be.
At the beginning, I'm like,
if he walks up, I'm going to eliminate him. I'm going to be like, he's physically fit and able to do this, so I have to eliminate him.
Yeah, rude. So let's watch from Survivor.
No offense.
This is just...
been taken.
This is just a little clip. There we go.
Oh, Lord.
First vote. Ken. Will not count.
No, this is the wrong one. Oh, yes, it is.
Jay, that's one vote,
long
Jay.
Hair.
My long hair is still there, baby.
Oh.
Jay, two votes.
Let
Jay.
It out.
Love you, God.
Follow the Son of the Spirit, baby.
15th person voted out, 8th member of our jury.
Damn. Oh, this was... I'm sorry.
That's when I played the fake idol and they got me out of there. That's the wrong one. Michaela wanted to punch me when I got out.
To the very end.
I had fun though.
Jay,
you're all warriors.
It was mad fun.
You too, Jay.
Man, have fun.
You too.
Man. Thank you.
That was a crazy experience.
Go ahead, Jeffrey.
Do it to me. I'm ready.
He's still calling the shots. Like at the end.
You'll be
time to go.
Well done.
Just wipe a tear?
Huh? I didn't really cry. I was just like improv shit.
Could you play for the TV? Oh, all right. Yeah. So that was Jay's last moment on Survivor. I thought you were going to last towards the very, very end.
Did not drop that puzzle, I was in it. Because even Adam told me, he's like, the next challenge was yours, hands down. Yeah. Like, you were the winner. So, but it all played out perfectly because in the end, Adam's mom was very sick, and my mom actually has brain aneurysms and all that stuff, but his mom had cancer. So his mom actually passed away 4 hours after he got home, and he called me and he's like, bro, like, he called me 2 days later. He's like, my mom passed away and all this. And I was like, dude, the universe works in mysterious ways. Cause like, he needed that. Cause he did that for his family. Cause he was supposed to play with his mom.
That's crazy.
Wow. I didn't even know that. Like, I just that's got wild. A little.
Yeah. So when he called me, it was hardcore. Like, everybody drink up.
Yeah.
It was hardcore because I was even like, bro, you have my mom, that's you have strong. My family, you can come whenever. So even Give Kids the World, we go every year together, and he dresses up like Mario, I dress up like Luigi because I'm taller, and I would be Mario in this case. He'd be Luigi, but we play with.
How tall you were in real life?
Oh, he's massive. Yeah. But in this case, we just hang out, play with the kids, hang out with them, and make them laugh. And last year was superb, and like all the kids were having so much fun. They're like, "Oh my god!" And we just pretended and just you forget about the reality TV thing, and you're just like, "I gotta beat Luigi for this little kid who is actually going through a terminal illness, and like he's a true survivor. Like we're just on the show."
Well, and I love when reality TV people use their position and their voice because when a show's peaked, it's there and you're in that bubble. You're doing the press for the network and people are messaging you and it's that energy. And some people can get wrapped up into it so that when that 15 minutes is over, it's over. And some people know how to carry that through. They know how to highlight their businesses and their other talents and exactly what they're doing. But it takes a good mind to do that. But also contributing to nonprofits is one of the best things you can do with your time on reality TV. And like I said, the episode with your sister, and I know you grew up, it was just you, your mom, and your sister. That was your family.
Well, yeah, my stepfather was there, but we didn't have like a good relationship at all. So it was just, in my mind, was me, my sister, and my mom. And like, let's do this, and it's us against the world, and whatever I have to do to make us survive, we're going to survive together. So that was it.
How do you think this close relationship with the women in your family has helped you in your business world and in your dating world, even though you're still single?
Oh, man.
Maybe it's because you're a mama's boy.
Oh, I'm a mama's boy legit. So I was raised right, and she told me what to do. Like him being respectful on his first episode and being like, I'll sleep on the couch if I have to. I would have said the same thing, no problem. But you also learn the secrets of women. So it's like,
ooh,
it's fun. Do you have an ebook for that?
Huh?
You have an ebook for that?
Shut up. You don't need an ebook, bro. We saw you.
What is your guys' the biggest regret that you have from doing reality TV, but what is the best thing that you have from doing reality TV?
Murray, you go first.
Oh.
You haven't spoken in a while.
My biggest regret from doing reality TV.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll definitely say my biggest regret from reality TV is that the network will play you however they want. It doesn't matter. You know what I mean? Like, everything that they have footage of is what they have footage of. But they can cut it and paste it however they want. And they don't make everybody look that great. Not only me, but there's other certain people in both shows that, like, didn't get a very good cut. You know what I mean? And there's nothing you can do about it because the show's already going on. The show's already played. Everybody's seen it. Everybody has their assumptions of your personality at that point. And, you know, as much as mine got played off in one way or another, like, I'm okay with that. You know, I have a tough shell and stuff. But there's people that were in both of my shows that don't have as, like, tough a skin.
Yes.
And, like, it really, really hit them hard.
Yes.
So I saw it, like, really, really fuck with people's, like, mind and emotions. And, you know, like, people get depressed on that kind of stuff. And, you know, when social media is great, but when people are attacking your social media for no reason because they think they know you, but they have no idea who you really are behind closed doors, that's what really sucks. You know what I mean? Like, I really saw it tear some people down. That's a bummer. Like, whatever. I don't care. Like, I am what I am, and I'm going to do what I want to do. So that's just kind of my personality anyway. So that's probably the worst thing that I saw out of any reality TV. But my favorite part is, I don't know. What is my favorite part? Do you know what?
Free booze?
No, they barely gave us any liquor. I was like begging for it all day, every day.
Oh, same.
See, so that's weird because
that's why
I had
to hide it, buddy.
Because on X
he's
on the
hiding
beach,
in shoes and things, and I'm like broke.
Yeah, but I was providing to everyone. It's like I was back on Survivor.
So that's so weird because it seemed on X on the Beach, you guys were doing nothing but drinking and laying by the pool and fighting. Yep. And I would think that they would want to. Paradise Hotel, there was barely any alcohol. It was very rare. Yeah. And then it's not like they had the bottles there. It was like a glass. And I was like, I would go insane. Yeah, you would think that they would want you liquored up.
Yeah, they really regulate it. That's so weird to me.
There were only three times where I honestly got pretty hammered about three times, but they didn't really show any of that footage. Unfortunately, I mean, that was like some of the best, funniest moments. Like, one dude fell over a bush. It was hilarious, but they just didn't show it. I was like, they missed
that was the worst that happened on the season. Like, a dude fell over a bush.
No. Jay jumped over a 25-foot ledge and like,
hi, I'm leaving.
Like Colton jumping over the
bigger gate. Jumped off this huge ledge. I don't know how he didn't break his legs.
Because I'm a fucking savage.
He's a survivor.
Yeah,
because I'm a survivor.
All right, Beyonce, calm down. I haven't heard that one before.
At least you didn't call me Michelle. Ew.
Okay, so the best part.
The best part of reality TV, I just think. You know, it's a really fun setting. As much as it's super intense sometimes, it's fun to be like dealing with the cameras and the production and the different personalities and like having to figure people out. People are crazy and people are fun. Some people are amazing. Some people suck. But you have to deal with all that and you have to deal with it on camera. I don't know. I think it's fun. I like the whole experience for the most part. Oh, boys, man. Your turn.
Girl. What's the biggest regret? Honestly, I guess my biggest regret out of my show is really it's more on the production side. Like, they didn't really get to show really who I was. I mean, honestly, I was 100% myself the whole time. I also understood that, you know, it was the cast and not America who decides who we won. So I was, you know, fairly quiet. I was very neutral between the different alliances. I played
the
game.
You were very quiet.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I schemed a good amount. Kendall and I played the game. We just did it very quiet, and it was never shown because we were the nice couple from California.
The problem is you played the game from the first episode. I think that's
why. What?
Because you couldn't, like, switch back and forth. You guys, maybe should have switched it up a little bit. No offense.
Yeah, we were the only couple who stayed together from first day till the day we were eliminated, and that was probably why we ended up not winning. But I mean, I just didn't get to show who I was. I mean, I like to crack like jackass comments and stuff like that and just kind of goof around. I mean, I got stitches on my head on the show. I cracked my head open on the doorway because I was just, you know, just fucking around, just running around sober, mind you, at 10 in the morning. I guess probably the best part of being on reality TV, you know, it was honestly the vacation I really needed for my own psyche, my own mental health.
It really was isolated too.
Oh my God. Yeah.
I mean, talk about isolation. Like, you guys were supposed to be isolated, but, like, you guys were cut. Like, when they showed the cameras, like, where are they?
Yeah, 5 minutes away is, like, cacti and, like, cows on the road. I didn't know there's cows on the road in Mexico. That's wild. But, I mean,
Mexicans can afford cows, too.
Oh, God. I mean, honestly, it was my favorite part of the show was
cows in Mexico. Wow.
Moo, moo.
My favorite.
Oh, my God.
Let me talk now, Murray. Is that okay with you?
Sorry, okay.
Yes. Okay.
I'm gonna be nice. I'm gonna be nice for 1 minute. That's it. Honestly, my favorite part. I mean, I was telling Kendall the whole time. You know, even if you and I don't continue to date each other outside of these like 3 or 4 weeks that we know, it was honestly just such a blessing just to be able to share that close interpersonal relationship with a female after not dating for so long, after having, you know, just honestly 3 just really tough, really bad relationships in my life. That it was such a blessing to. You know, honestly, come home and have that friendship with her. Her and I aren't seeing each other every single day. We're still kind of figuring out. Honestly, it's confusing. It's really hard transitioning that relationship. But I was just so thankful to be able to spend a lot of good quality time with a great, amazing, beautiful girl.
Well, and she did become your friend because Paradise Hotel was vicious. Like, you guys were competing against each other, but you guys also had the moment of friendship and that you were, you know, at your limits. But Paradise Hotel, people were not nice.
No.
And it was very surface, and it was a quick time, and it was, I mean, the whole show was kind of a superficial type. It's like the looks first.
Absolutely.
And so you kind of needed that friendship quality.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm thankful to still have that out of her. Her and I are both, I'm building my personal training business. She's coming out with some sort of line that hasn't come out yet. I'm not going to ruin that surprise, but she's working on her own sort of
vibrators.
Business. Something like that. No.
he was testing them out. He's like, I like this one.
hey, Kendall, I saw this one today.
Yeah.
Super cool. Nah, she's got that going on. She's traveling overseas modeling. She's doing her thing. You know, I respect that. And, you know, I'm just looking. I believe that, you know, whatever's supposed to happen is going to. If we end up together, it's supposed to happen. If not, you know, I still have a great friend.
Cute. That's cute.
So, message from the chat room. Reason why they limit the booze. There has been some issues on some reality shows.
Excellent.
Where there's been some sexual assault lawsuits. Not Excellent
Beach. Oh, really?
And not so excellent. That's why they limit that. I guess.
Interesting. Hmm.
Okay. So back to best worst. The biggest thing.
Best and worst, girl. What you gonna give it?
Best and worst, girl. The best thing about reality television would have to be the experiences and meeting all the different people and like ending up in situations like this that you would never imagine as a kid growing up. You're just like, but that's not gonna happen.
Yeah.
And then now I'm sitting here in a room with like Murray and like doing stupid shit with him on Thursdays at the Abbey and then meeting him, and I want to corrupt the freaking pastor's child. Like, oh, let's mess him up.
I need a bad influence in my life. Honestly, like,
I am the worst influence.
Right?
I don't sit there on a Friday and be like, I want to go get fucked up. I want someone to like tempt me to do this.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna say no.
Come hang
like,
out.
Like, I'm scared.
We got you, boo. We got you.
My brand is stay local. Between
us, like, the three of us couldn't be more different. We got you covered on every aspect. Literally. Of getting
I'm
into
excited
trouble.
For it. Even like, I mean, I don't know if I'm gonna go, but I mean, I guess we'll have to see.
I'll test out the water.
The only thing,
how about that?
Don't worry.
Church is on Sunday. That's the only thing.
But yeah, just meeting all the people and having experiences like this, and like just getting to travel the world and enjoy life, and like open up your horizons to like all sorts of different things, and like learn things from freaking everyone, you know. So, and then the worst experience from reality television was. I was looking forward to MTV showing the fact that I beat Murray's ass in a skinny dipping race at the margarita pool. What's up? Did I not beat you? Tell the truth.
I feel like Cheyenne raced you and I didn't.
You raced me, you drunk fuck.
Do you know what? I don't really remember, so I can't really say.
We're in the hot tub, me, Morgan, Cheyenne.
I remember skinny dipping.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
And then they're like, the only way that you guys can come into this hot tub and enjoy our margarita date is if you skinny dip. And I'm like, well, this is going to be interesting with my boys at home. So I skinny dip with Murray and Cheyenne and Morgan. And, like, of course, Morgan's in heaven. Like,
yeah,
everyone's chilling there.
She's great tits.
Yeah.
Amazing. And then I don't know who came up with the bet, but it was like, oh, whoever's going to race gets to get the
Cheyenne did that.
The boom boom room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The one room in the house that, like,
yeah.
We get it.
There's one camera in the ceiling. So Cheyenne bets, and I'm like, okay, I'm down. Let's race. And then Murray's like, I'm gonna do it. So
just like that,
you skinny dip.
No,
race.
I feel like you really raced Cheyenne. I'm pretty
I
sure.
I raced you.
Okay. Well, either way, you.
How
won,
was the
so
view,
whatever.
Murray Swanby?
He was still swimming. He couldn't see. He was
from the hero view. Oh, it's big. I've heard things look bigger from my name, but not from my experience.
We'll show you. okay, we have some questions from the chat room. Luis Andres Pena, Murray, what advice did you give Billy? Billy Eichner is actually coming on the show in a few weeks to talk about. He's in the new season of X on the Beach.
Yeah.
What advice did you give him? Because you worked with him on What Happens at the Abbey.
I did. And do you know what? Oh, wait. Hold on. Just 1 second. All right. Okay, so I don't know what I can say or what I can't say.
Just
so
drink
just
from the bottle, man.
Why are you looking at
Give
the
me a
wall?
Shot. What's the wall over there?
What's that wall over there?
So I told Billy we had a really opportunity for you. I was like, you've already done reality TV before. I said, do you know what? To be honest, MTV really, you know, they'll portray you probably much better. It's a whole different genre of people that watch it. And I said, so keep yourself out there, you know, do all these things. I can't go into a lot of the things that I said because you're going to have to see it on TV. You know, he asked me about...
There is a big twist coming that you do need to watch for.
You do.
Yes.
And so I just talked to him about his relationships and, you know, if he I don't know, just everything. You know, he has all these things and... Do I really want this person to fly out here and be on camera or not? And I'm like, you don't have to tell them everybody. You know, if there's a couple crazies in there, just kind of leave them in the closet. Keep those skeletons there. But, you know, tell them about a few people that you actually had good connections with. And then throw in one spicy one because they need to show up too.
And good TV is good TV.
Yeah.
And you, I mean, part of you, you literally were playing a competition. You were playing a competition while finding love. I mean, it was a competition. X on the Beach was a little bit different because it was more relationship based and there wasn't like a prize money. But as a reality TV personality, you always are mindful that there's a camera watching. What is the audience going to respond? How am I going to keep my storyline going? Otherwise, as we've seen on Bravo, if you're boring for 10 minutes, you're off of the next season. You're not part of the show. And if you're trying to build your business or trying to build your brand, that is on your mind constantly is, okay, let's be somebody that somebody's talking about. And sometimes you've got to make it a little crazier. You need to be a bigger version of yourself.
Well, the one good thing about X on the Beach compared to Paradise Hotel is that they kind of made you do that. And you probably had to really stick with that relationship or whatever you had going on through a lot of the show. Which, do you know what? When you're on these shows, time passes by so slow. Like one day feels like you've been talking to
each other for weeks
or months or whatever. It just, like by the end of our show, I was like, I swear to God, I lived with these people for over a year. I knew them better than people I've lived with for a year. You know what I mean? You don't have phones. You don't have internet, magazines,
you don't have
books,
anything. You're literally
TV,
just talking
nothing.
To each other
so you just
all day.
Talk all day. Sorry, I don't know when I can swear, whatever.
That's fine.
But our show was different because we didn't have to have that. You just had to have a good connection with the with the group of people that was there because you got voted out. Yeah. So it's a little bit different in that sense.
That's what happened to me. Like
that's a bummer.
The group voted us out.
Oh.
But there was a really real shift towards the end because like we had wanted to see people in love and then like the very last episode it was like, okay, it's for the money. That twist, and if you haven't watched Paradise Hotel, you have to watch the twist.
Absolutely.
Would you have shared the money half and half?
Absolutely, there's no way. Honestly,
wait. How does this work? I don't know.
Okay, so do you want to get it? Or I get it?
You're in the show. You do it.
Okay, how is it?
It's your show.
Okay, so they're like the prize is $250,000. Like, does the couple get it, or they're like, no, it's the prize. So the couple, Bobby.
Do you know this before you couple up?
Yes, I mean we don't know how it's gonna end.
Okay.
So Bobby and Tatum win. So they have like golden balls filled with confetti, and there's different dollar amounts leading up to $250,000. If they like hold the ball and don't drop it. Until they reach $250,000, then it's like they split it $125,000 each. But if you drop it, whatever dollar amount you're on, you go home with that. So they get to $200,000, and the guy throws it down, and the girl gets nothing. She goes back to her room. I honestly, Tatum,
when she deserved it.
Yeah, she did. We honestly all talked about it. We're like, if Bobby does it,
but you said that you would have dated her if you weren't with Kendall.
I was gonna go with Tatum because like
she would have been awful for you. She would have thrown you out in the morning.
She won, did she not?
Can you
she
switch?
Won.
Did she win?
People through halfway through the show the or no?
Yeah.
People
you
were
switch
switching.
All the time. You could.
People were switching literally. In fact, Carlos, if he didn't have such a good booty, I would be like,
guy.
I don't even want to see him. But he was so good. But he literally
he's also 5'2".
How about
I don't care because
looks like a box.
A box.
Yeah, a Christmas box I want to open. Okay.
Please
no.
do.
So, but Murray, he literally went to the beach with some girl. When he came back, the girl that he was with, he was like, oh, yeah, I'm done with you. Literally. And she was like, wait, what?
Yeah.
It happened like
fierce. Spa day. Girls had spa
That's
day.
That's probably way harder for you without having a lot of like that dating or sexual history with people. You know what I mean?
I've done
but
sex.
But Kendall was
it's
all about
to
that,
dump
though.
Somebody though to be like, yeah, do you know what? I don't think you're the best player. I'm just gonna go hook up with this girl. Like,
that's
I,
exactly.
I
what
would be able to do it
to
much easier.
Players.
You know what I mean? Like, I'd be like, bye, bitch.
Honestly, about when I,
that's jealousy. It's fine.
When I came into the show, I was like, this is for the money. I'm gonna have my family. Forget whoever I'm with. About halfway through the show, I mean, I got whipped. I get whipped easy, man. This is the fact.
I have a quote though.
Preacher's child.
Gentlemen, do not say this on a date or when you're ready to get intimate. This is an actual quote from David Barta from Paradise Hotel.
Oh God, what do we got?
I would do sex with you.
we were
40-year-old
bad. I literally had to stop and write that. I was like, I had to rewind it. I was like, no, he did not say this. He was like, I would do sex with you.
No, we were goofing around. It was based off a joke that Bobby.
It was cute moment. But
it was based off of a joke. We were just having a conversation. I forget what was going on.
You know what David?
Do
you know what David's like? He's like that guy. You know what's the actor from Ant-Man that he's on like Wanderlust?
Paul Rudd.
Yes, yes, and he's in the mirror and he's like, "You want the dick? You want the dick? Ah." That's David practicing before. I would do it to sex.
We're doing the sex.
I forget what that was about, but I mean,
it was a
say,
cute moment.
I was like, I'd do sex with you, like hypothetically speaking.
Oh,
that's not how you say it, girl.
The dream. Every
how
girl.
Do you,
was,
how do you say it, Murray? How do you say it?
I would have sex. I would have sex with you. It's not. I would do sex to you.
Don't even say sex. That ruins it all. Like, word it differently.
What do you say?
Don't say anything.
Alexander, what
do
you say? When you're pronouncing that you're desiring the sex from a partner, what do you say?
Your brain's out.
This is Alexander.
No, I would say, there's the pillow, put your face in it. Okay.
Ew, Sam.
Welcome to the triangle. Yeah.
Okay, more questions from the chat room. Question from Clarence for Jay. What made you stick with the Stay Loco lifestyle brand to build your whole clothing line? What does Stay Loco actually mean to you? Because it's a fun saying. The clothing line looks great.
Oh, thank you.
And it's fun, it's playful. I think it really encapsulates your personality. But what does Stay Loco mean for you?
So Stay Loco is basically like every single person in this room right now has their own type of crazy, right? So when you do something to yourself that's true to yourself and someone's like, oh my God, you're crazy. Like, why would you ever do that? That's your loco. So stay your loco no matter what you do, no matter where you go, always be true to yourself and just do you.
Like if I want to party hard or I want to get 7% body hard, fat for international, you
7% yeah. body fat, show your leg angles so that your wiener's not popping out, like whatever, you know, like
I cover my wiener in photos first.
I know your legs do. You're all over my Instagram. Don't worry. You're not shadow banned from my feed. Anyways, just be true to yourself and who you are and like just stay your crazy. Stay your loco.
And I love that because it's for any stage of your life. Old, young, rich, poor, entertainment, not entertainment.
Just stay loco.
Just stay true to yourself.
Yep.
I love that. Okay. Oh, David.
Oh, boy.
Sorry.
Oh, Alexander.
This is from the chat room. At what age, Mrs. Barta, don't listen. At what age did you lose your virginity?
Oh,
19.
Wait, so you lost your virginity before you even watched porn? How did you know what to do?
I asked.
Did you say, how do we do it the sex?
No, he's like, I would say,
this and that.
I mean, I understood the mechanics. I understood the mechanics of the whole deal. It's like baseball.
Had you watched,
pull your arm back. And
baseball? Okay.
You know, there's a dance with everything. It's the dance with no pants.
The dance with no
You guys, David Bartz is going to have his book of poetry. He's like, I would sex with you to dance with no pants or dance in my pants. Oh my God, you guys. Okay.
A lot of poets in the family, actually, believe it or not. From
a lot
Iowa.
Of what?
Yeah. A lot of poets. Poets and farmers from Iowa.
Oh, they're
you know
so proud.
I would believe them.
Are those metaphors for sex?
So 19, I think, no, that's a little old. Okay.
I actually had a purity ring.
A whatty who?
It's a purity
ring. It's very popular.
Like Jonas Brothers kind of thing. Like, yeah. you have a ring, it's like you're like promised to God.
It's like a class ring, only nerdier.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. If you have a purity ring, I support you.
Yeah, same. Okay.
So it's a ring that you wear like this.
Yes. Yeah, I wore it on a necklace. Actually, in that baseball picture, it was like.
Wait, you're supposed to wear it on your finger so people know you're being. Oh, you wanted to keep it.
He didn't want to throw it off.
Yeah. It was too small.
Okay, so the day after you had sex, did you just throw it away? It's a real question.
The girl who I lost my virginity to, once we stopped talking, threw it in the ocean. I felt like I was like, well, you gave it to the person.
Her.
Yeah, it's like the person you lose to. Who's
did you guys throw it in the ocean together like Titanic?
That's exactly where I was going. It was like,
bitch, bye.
No, she did it plenty by herself.
Bye, girl.
It's like, how long did it take you to lose your virginity? It's been 82 years. Like, that's that meme, right?
Yes, exactly.
Actually, I really find that respectful. And there are people that choose to hold on to their... I'm making light of it, but there's a large population that they get their confidence from that and exploration of their faith.
Absolutely.
So I'm joking with you, but your choice is your choice.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, on a real note, I mean, it gave me an opportunity to experience like sex with someone else, but also, you know, understand it on my own because I grew up in the church. Like, you will not. It's not if you do. It's you will not. I mean, I got to understand that on my own. That helped me grow up a lot more really in the past 2 years. So on a real note, that in my walk in faith and struggle with God, I mean, it was an important step that I took, and I'm thankful and I'm glad that it happened.
All right. Jay, after the show, when was the last time that you hooked up with Morgan after the show was started filming?
After X on the Beach? Yeah. I never hooked up with Morgan after X on the Beach.
Really?
Yeah, she left to the challenge 4 days later.
Yeah, Morgan was literally left X on the Beach, repacked her clothes, left for challenge.
So like we hooked up like the 4 days, like, but that doesn't really count. She left for challenge immediately.
Oh.
And then when she came back, I found out news and I was like, oh.
Which, I love you, Morgan, but that was pretty rude.
Facts. You guys, we're getting very interesting questions from the chat room, and I just want to say to you guys, you can answer or not answer.
I'm very excited.
And there's lots more vodka, by the way.
Oh, boy.
Murray, ladies and gentlemen. Who was better in bed, Cheyenne or Corey Z?
Or Jay.
Wow. Can I watch?
I don't know. Do you know what they're
both doing? Who said fuck,
that?
David?
That wasn't me.
Huh? Are you exploring everything now that you've just...
No. I think you should watch everything. Yeah,
you said you did it.
I feel like Cheyenne was more like... Yeah, he hasn't had sex with me yet.
I heard
If I have to turn gay, Murray
said
that
I
have... You
guys, this is live, by the way.
Yeah, that's fine.
Listen to this. This is the best story you'll ever hear.
Yeah.
Murray said that if I ever turn gay, I have to have sex with him first.
And I said okay.
Because I think Murray would be gentle.
No, no, no. You didn't say okay. That's what you told
me.
Yeah, that's what you told me to do. So
that's true.
Okay. Okay, but so answer the question.
Okay, so I would say that they're both pretty good in bed, but like Cheyenne's connection with me is probably a little more intimate, and Corey Z is like a little more like angry, bang, whatever, bang it out.
Hate fuck.
Yeah.
Sometimes you need that.
Yeah.
Hate beep.
Sorry.
What would you guys have done with all the money that you would have won for Survivor, and what would you have done with the money that you won? Now, besides, because we know you wanted to help out your family,
yeah.
What would you selfishly have done with a portion of that for yourself?
Ooh. I would have bought me a Jeep Wrangler four-door lifted.
Yeah,
girl, you would look good in that riding up to Abby. Boop, boop.
Right?
Yeah.
then I would leave it in the garage and go travel the entire world and try to surf all the coolest spots in the world and just live.
I have a feeling when you're like 75, you're going to be on the beach and your hair is going to be this long. It's going to be gray. You're going to have a little receding hairline and you're going to have like a Hawaiian shirt and cargo shorts that fit loosely, but you're going to tell the best stories and people are just going to come and listen to your stories because you are going to travel and travel and have these amazing stories.
And I'm going to play the ukulele and just be like, bah, bah,
bah. You don't need to do that.
Why not?
Okay.
Ukulele's dope, man. If you're chill on the beach, just chill.
I don't think a girl was ever like, and he plays the ukulele.
I love
it. But
in
Hawaii, it's so cute.
It's so dope. It's like, but thank you for thinking that I'll reach 70 because all the stupid shit I do, I don't know.
You just never know. You never know. Like,
you should actually just go to Hawaii now and start playing that.
Oh, I'm planning. No, no, September's coming.
I would buy that album, though. Couldn't you see? It's like Jay Starrett's biggest hits. He's like, ding, 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 ding. What would you have selfishly have done with that?
Oh, man, what's something I've always wanted? Shit.
With your whole $100,000.
Yes, after tax, about 80.
Yeah.
So how about that?
Sorry, bitch. Chose the wrong show.
Honestly, I have always wanted to go on like a nice vacation to Hawaii with like a partner, so I probably would have taken.
Boring.
Like Kendall. Why is that boring?
Because it is.
And probably like
Hawaii.
And then with like the $10 I had after that, like a vibrator.
$10 doesn't buy you a vibrator.
You should test it out. I'm not gonna lie. It's a totally different orgasm.
Go to Murray's house. Where does Murray put it?
I mean, no, not him.
You only have one hole, girl.
As a dude.
Okay, so let's talk about something else then.
Anyways.
Thank you, Cara. Thank you, Cara. That's to get back.
I just want to go to Hawaii. That's all I was trying to get out of that.
Okay, so Jay, I have some silly questions.
All right, let's
actually,
do it.
They're not silly. Sorry, listeners.
Are they rapid fire?
Rapid fire. No, I have rapid fire questions for you all.
Fuck
but me. This is more about survival, about the nuts and bolts. Where the hell do people go to the bathroom on Survivor Island?
Okay, so this is always a question that I get. If you go with someone else and you say, I'm going to go number one, and we go together, a camera will follow you. Because it doesn't matter because you might be talking strategy. Otherwise, go alone. And you just, you can either dig a hole and shit in a hole.
No.
Or you can go into the ocean and aqua dump.
Please don't tell me that happened.
What do you like wipe with? Like,
you're in the ocean. You're floating in the toilet.
That's why you go in the ocean.
That's why you're in the ocean. You're literally.
That's the most disgusting thing I've ever heard in my entire life.
What's the problem with that? I did that before Survivor.
It's like, I did it right.
Whatever. It floats.
That's different. A little different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm literally
trust me,
right now.
I'll let you know that coconuts are a laxative, so don't eat 9 of them. Because for 2 days, it's going
to
suck.
I don't even know what to say. How bad does everybody smell?
It depends on the person.
But because there's no showers.
Some people
Girl,
don't.
There's an ocean.
Yeah, but
some
but
people
the ocean
don't
has bacteria,
shower. Dude.
And now we know it has
the ocean
crap
be like
floating around.
Rubbing
well,
sand
it's not like the
water.
Whole ocean is full. Oh, where do you think your shit
In
goes
mind,
right now?
Heaven.
It oh, your sense. Flowers go directly to heaven?
Yes, girl.
Okay. no, you just shit in the ocean, it floats away, or some fucking fish probably eats it. Who knows? But then
nobody knows for sure.
That's like the worst fish in the world, by the way. SeaWorld is not like, here's the shit-eating fish. Look at it, do a trick.
Well, if they had that fish, I wouldn't support SeaWorld because they captivate the animal. Anyways, you can like scrub with sand and you can just go into the ocean, clean up and exfoliate and whatever.
What fun. Okay.
Some people smell like
and
shit.
During your season, people actually hooked up and I was like, who wants to hook up with somebody that's smelly and sleeping in the dirt?
My
and
dude. So like the chick that hooked up with Taylor, yeah. No offense, Figgy, I love you very much. But you two are filthy. Because like honestly, she was hot. Oh, like out of the show, I was like, oh my God, I want to hook up with her. She's so beautiful. Da 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 da. Then we get on the show and I'm like, we haven't brushed our teeth in 5 days.
No.
And then towards the end, like, I didn't brush my teeth for 36 days. When I tell you I came back with whiter teeth than anyone in this room, it's true because you don't eat anything with food coloring. You don't eat any of the bad stuff.
Wine.
You're just, like, glowing, and you're tan-skinned, and everything's perfect.
Oh.
And the doctor's like, oh, well, the dentist goes to me, and he's like, oh my God, your teeth are so clean. I was like, really? I haven't brushed my teeth in 36 days. You're apparently a terrible fucking dentist.
That's so weird to me. I got this from email. You were pushed to the limits mentally and physically. You lost 12 pounds during your journey, and you didn't even have those 12 pounds when you hit the island to even do that. What did you learn most about yourself from day one to day 36?
So day one, I wanted to quit. No lie. Yeah, the cyclone hit and I was sleeping in the rain for 13 hours and I literally was cuddling other people, shaking to the point where the cold is not cold.
And it wasn't just rain, you guys. It was a life-threatening cyclone.
We got evacuated, so it was legit. I dug a hole underneath a raft so that everyone could sleep. And by everyone, I mean like 5 people. And we all just stuck in there and trying to like cuddle. You'd cuddle a dude, you'd cuddle a chick. It didn't matter at that point. You're just sitting there. If you think you're the straightest dude in the world, or it didn't matter. You're just
body heat.
It's just literally person to person, I need you. And the greatest thing that I learned from Survivor was I can literally do anything and don't ever judge anyone or anything and just be so open to life in itself, because everyone is beautiful in their own aspect of life and you meet so many different people, and if you judge a book by its cover, you're the idiot.
And that's what I love, and that's what I love about this show, On the Rocks, is you never know who's going to be here on Tuesday. You know, we have people from all different sexualities, entertainment fields, and this is the conversation we have, and this is what I loved about X on the Beach, was that it wasn't even a big deal. It's like, we have straight couples, we have gay couples. It wasn't even made an issue. You guys seem to become friends, you with the girls, you with the guys, you with, it didn't even matter. And it was just so seamless.
No, literally.
Other than the drama.
On X on the Beach, I was so happy because I learned so much from, like, even Murray. Like, no offense, I'm a straight dude. But, like, I had Cheyenne fucking on my back, massaging my back. And, like, other dudes from home would be like, yo, what are you doing? Like, and I'm like, you're an idiot. Open your fucking eyes, dude.
Yeah.
Because the world is so much bigger than this stupid shit. Like equality vodka. We are all equal. But honestly, we're all equal and we're all people, so just love each other no matter what, because at the end of the day, we're all going back into the ground anyways. Yeah, whether true. You're ash or whether you get buried, it's all going to disintegrate, and at the rate that we're going, there won't be any of it. So
yeah, true that. So also, a lot of the guys in the house, like, obviously none of them have ever lived with a gay guy. And living in that house, like I said, time goes so slow. It feels like you spent over a year living with somebody. So at the end of it, like, literally, I don't think one of them didn't come to me or Cheyenne or Jose.
Rob.
And be like, you guys, like, honestly, like, this was such an eye-opening experience. And, like, really, it was just really fucking cool to, like, I wouldn't just normally like say, hey, I'm going to go live with a gay guy for like a while or a year or whatever or a month or anything. And they're like, it was just so awesome. So I think changing people's perceptions and things and being like, you know, we're just here living, like, me and Cheyenne are doing our own thing and like everybody else is doing their own couple thing. And like nobody, it's not like we're like throwing ourselves at the guys and like trying to like lick your neck.
I think that's the biggest thing. It's like,
we don't care. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean?
Yep.
You're like, most straight guys are not that attracted to.
And we can flirt, like,
to be honest.
We flirt with straight guys. You know, you guys.
I flirt with gay dudes.
I was flirting with gay dudes. I was flirting
free drinks
with
gay dudes. Unless
you're so threatening.
No, we flirted with each other all the time. Yeah. Honestly, you know what one of my favorite things was the fact that after the show, you remember when my sister came?
Yeah.
And it was her birthday?
Yeah, yeah.
She's like, oh, brother, like, I want to go out. And she calls him a brother. Yeah, everybody says. It's weird. But, like, we went out, and I took her to the Abbey, and she had the best time ever. I've never seen my sister so comfortable.
Melanie would be very popular at the Abbey.
Oh, dude. Yeah. She was dancing, killing it, having a ball, and Murray's just taking care of her. And I was so, like, dude, thank you for that experience, because that was an experience for me that will not end. And to you, it must have meant nothing, but to me, it was like...
No, I love that kind of stuff. You know what I mean?
Like, no, it's truth.
That's why I do my job.
That was truth.
I love inviting people to the venues I work at, like the Abbey, Rocco's. Like, I really love it because you give.
I love Rocco's, by the way. It's yeah. So open. It's like space wise open, but it's really open. It's like
all the walls are windows, so it's like fierce.
I have a favorite club in WeHo.
You what?
I have a favorite club in WeHo.
What?
I used to work at Mickey's for 6 months, actually.
How about that?
Serious.
What year? Are you guys? I'm not even kidding.
This year, honestly, till the day that I left for the show. I was personal
trainer. Oh my god.
Listen, Alex.
But you were like super, super skinny.
Huh?
Were you like 6% body fat?
I mean, I was. Yeah, oh my god. I guess.
I remember you now.
Were you. If it was from December up until what, April when I left for the show, I was working there. I mean, I started working there. I was like, I was low on cash and I was like, shoot, I need to make money. I was selling shots. I mean, honestly, like you two were talking about, it really helped me get acclimated and around like the LGBTQ community, which is something I didn't grow up with. Being a pastor's kid, so honestly, it made me a more tolerant, more understanding, more accepting man, person, and citizen. Really,
I love that.
Well,
I had a fun time
because guess who's in your congregation at your church? People that haven't come out yet, people that are out, sure, that you know, sure. And this is what religion should bring us all to is a brothership. But I do want to take a peek at some of the footage that we didn't get to see from Paradise Hotel.
What are we looking at?
How about that?
So let's just take a little peek because we didn't even get to see you and Kendall kind of like do that much. Yeah, no. Do the sex.
I watched clips today.
Yeah.
Like I was like, I want to see what this.
Everyone thought this was the first time we made out. It wasn't. Her and I were.
You could tell this is not the first
time.
Her
and I were hooking up since day two. This was like day five or six.
And the other couples are actually, because there's actually feelings behind that kiss. It wasn't like,
yeah.
Kurt, can we have the volume up a little bit? It wasn't like the other couples. When they kissed, it was scary.
I remember watching this with my roommate and being like, what the fuck? I want to be on the show.
This was your first moment.
Oh, God, no.
Turn this up, Kurt.
This is, I misspoke so bad right here. This is brutal.
You were more interested in that shish kebab.
I ate the shit out of that thing.
Yep.
Were you drunk right there?
No, I was sober. Unfortunately. Okay. I wish I was drunk.
Here it is.
Listen. Yikes.
Oh. And there's an awkward pause.
I honestly felt embarrassed that I said I love you to more people than Kendall in that moment. Because I was like, oh, like I don't want her to think that I'm immature because she's 26 and I'm 21. Kind of such like that. I mean, I date older women. I felt like such an idiot. I was trying to make it up to her here.
Those pants are your best friend, by the way.
Khakis?
The ones on.
Just pants in general.
I feel like no pants are your best friend.
See, but
honestly, I watch this video, this moment.
This is cute.
A couple times a week, to be honest with you.
It's really sweet. And this is what...
I mean, you're trapped in a house, so like, you find trust and you just latch on.
Yeah, I'm glad you paused it there because it was just kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have more questions. Murray.
Yes. Also, somebody was just writing on my live that they were commenting and they wanted you to ask a question.
Okay, what's the question?
I don't know now because it's like shot through all the.
Okay, so this question is for me. Who has better abs, in my opinion, Murray or David? And can we see proof?
Take your shirts off.
This is
idiots.
A classy show. We've had Academy
Award
winners.
Your shirt's see-through, guys.
Actually, while we were hanging out like for the 30 minutes before this having a cocktail, like he was shirtless. And I'm like, why don't you just do the whole shirt show?
Wait a minute. What?
I agree.
You guys, he showed up 1 minute to broadcast.
I worked at Mickey's.
No, and he was shirtless.
What do you want me to do?
All three of us were like chilling for a little bit.
He's trying to get the 7%. I was even like, whoa.
You're so nice.
Cameras there.
You're so nice.
Cameras there. You're so nice.
Wait, is that the camera? I just stand up and just do this.
I guess, yes. Kurt, though, I think being a straight man, you should be the one to say who has the better abs, so there's no, like, yeah, okay.
Just don't make any more jokes.
Stand up. No more puns, Kurt.
No more puns. I can't promise anything.
Okay.
So, like, lean down, like, what's going on?
No, he said, absolutely.
Oh, no, this is actually perfect, because it's right on your abs.
That was a good one.
Oh, no, no. So
you like that, Kurt, right?
Yeah, that was a good one.
Kurt, put the camera just on Murray.
What about that? Wait.
Are you guys flexing? You can't flex in this picture.
No, no flexing. Okay, go ahead.
Because we'll know.
Yeah.
No flexing. You're flexing.
Yeah, he's flexing.
You're flexing.
You don't shave your chest, guy?
What?
You don't shave your chest?
Yeah, he does. Do you not see?
It's not that hairy, girl.
It's not that hairy.
I shave like...
Okay, okay, next. You guys...
I don't have that much chest hair. Thank you. Oh, wait, let me turn my phone around.
Whatever, love.
Wait, how about this? Can my phone see you or not?
This is why I made money at Mickey's.
Okay. I almost just passed out, by the way. Jesus Christ. Okay, Kurt, and the applause for the best ab goes to...
Jay.
I mean, both of us.
How about it?
How about it?
I would probably say Murray.
Oh! Yeah. He chose Murray!
Yeah.
I chose you.
Okay, so applause. That's so sweet. You know what? We're all winners.
Congratulations,
here.
Murray. What does Murray win off that? Alexander, what does Murray win?
Another glass of equality vodka.
Yay.
Well, that's boring.
That's my favorite.
I was
going to
say from me, but you didn't let me finish.
I mean, you could give me a kiss or something, but I don't want to push it.
Okay, where? Okay.
Where?
Okay.
You said you wanted some chapstick.
I just messed up my microphone. How about that? Okay, here we go.
Okay.
You can't button back up, man.
No, you can't.
The whole internet's watching. Just stay unbuttoned.
The world is watching.
Stay loco. Right?
Stay loco.
I love the outfit, but we need to talk about the color scheme.
More. That's one button.
You don't like purple,
if you need a wardrobe blue. Stylist, I would bring over clothes that were two sizes too small and be like, oh, God, it's too small.
I should take it off.
I do have a stylist. He gave me a bag of clothes last night. And
a bag of clothes? Yeah. That's how you know your stylist.
A bag of clothes.
It was like hung up, and he goes, "Here, wear this." I mean, he styled me the past couple events we went to. We went to like a domestic abuse event, like a runway for the benefit of like sexual abuse survivors. I mean, it was like sequin suits, and like they were dope. They were sweet. His name's Sarmi Reyes. He's great. But
I'm just kidding. I'm sure your stylist.
Yeah, you should keep your clothes on for those.
Bag of clothes.
I most definitely did. I buttoned up all the way.
Well, my fan just said, I picked the purple shirt guy, but it's not a competition. So that was nice.
We're all winners.
Everyone's a winner.
He didn't ask.
Well, maybe you should follow him and also follow me. So how about
it? You're shadow blocked, so you got to scroll.
Oh, also, I had the question. They rewrote it. He said something about meeting Ava Max, which I met in New York Pride last weekend. Like, not this weekend, the weekend before.
World Pride, yeah.
World Pride. It was amazing. I play Ava Max literally on repeat. Like, I played it when it first came out on repeat for an entire night at our house, like drinking with like 20 of my friends for 6 hours or so. And they're like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, turn it off. And I'm like, no.
No, girl.
So I played it for 6 hours. So all of my like friends were like writing about it on social media. They're like, this is like, whatever. She's crazy. Like, stop playing it, Murray. Like, it was just random statuses. But I met her at New York World Pride and she was amazing. And I absolutely love her. So that was awesome.
Yeah, Ava.
So that was awesome.
What did you guys do the first minute when you got home? And I want to know from Survivor, because that was a little bit more dramatic. You had a little transition before you actually got home. But your moment home and your moment from X on the Beach, when you walk back into your house, your apartment, wherever it was, what was the first thing that you really wanted to do? Like, what was the first day like back at home?
What did we want to do?
Or what was the first day?
Yeah, like what was the first day like? What was most important for you to do that you missed the most?
I mean, honestly, I hadn't really lived with my family for about a year. I hadn't seen my sister for almost a year. So, I mean, coming home, I really had absolutely no idea what to expect. I mean, I understand I had some explaining to do for sure. But I just wanted to really understand the climate of where I was coming home to and just, you know, decide, like, is it cool for me to be here still? Or, like, is my family not okay with the career decisions I've made, and should I pack up and like go somewhere else? I mean,
I think that's not to take it down, but I think that's really important to know is as reality TV stars, you know, the assumption from mainstream is like, oh, you know, you guys get to go to the parties and, you know, everybody loves you and they're on your Instagram and whether you have little trolls or not, but it seriously affects the rest of your life.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Whether you do one show, whether you do two shows. And I think it's important for people to know this aspect of it.
None of us in this room can be lawyers. Like, after reality TV, you're done.
Yeah.
Doctors.
Or lawyers, a politician.
You can do whatever you want, girl.
Okay, girl.
Be who you want.
But,
I'm not sure I'd want you as my lawyer.
Okay, judgment.
You have to be like.
He's not afraid to charge.
I object. Stay loco.
Stay loco. I object. What was the question?
No. But this important aspect is not knowing whether you should stay home or not. I mean, that's pretty intense when your family and your way of life, that's all you knew.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, things are so much better now. Honestly, like, I'm fairly busy every single day. I've been working nonstop. I'm building my personal training brand. I've been going to commercial auditions like 4 or 5 days a week. A lot of people ask me, like, what I do. What do you do outside of working out? It's like, you know, like, I do modeling as well. I'm on commercial auditions. I play a single dad every single time I go to a commercial audition.
That's so funny.
It was so funny. Like, it's like the cutest little kids, but it's like, oh, you're the dad. And I was like, well, I'm okay with that. I know. I actually had this little, like, dream about being, like, a single dad. Not by, like, not getting someone pregnant, but, like, if someone's, like, like, if
I have dreams about that. Being How about single you dad? Getting somebody pregnant? How about that?
Do you?
We're not talking about you right now.
I'm just kidding. Go ahead. Just
like, not like, or being like, I don't want a baby mom. I want to get them pregnant and stuff like that. But, like, if someone were to, like, hey, we have this child we can't take care of, be like, I love kids. Like,
I could see a sitcom with you as, like, the single dad with, like, all of that. And, like, have all the cool friends that come over and be like, girl, we're going to help you out.
It's always, like, Hallmark Channel. Like,
I've
had, like, some, all of, like, how my, like, public appearances and, like, Instagram is all, like more sexual than not, or kind of like, oh, like, gym selfie, like, abs kind of stuff like that. But then, like, commercial, I get sent out on a lot of, like, oh, cute single dad, or, like, cute guy that's, like, the boyfriend kind of stuff like that. I'm like, Carol, come on, let's do some, like, sexy shit. You understand me?
I feel like that's also, well, I don't know about the ending about that, but I feel like it's also.
I like saying it.
I also think that the millennial generation is more like, I can raise a kid on my own. I think guys feel like that, and I think girls feel like that.
An idea of what a family is has changed, too.
It is. It used to be like you, I don't know. It was like my grandparents' generation that people, like, really, really stuck together. My parents' generation, my parents are still together, but most people's aren't. Like, their generation just didn't, like, marriage really wasn't that big to them. You know what I, because everybody got divorced. Like, what?
Divorce rate is now 52%.
52%? Oh, yeah. I was like,
why don't we just bring that up?
it's just a whole thing. And
girl,
I think,
get a girlfriend first.
And I think. Same. And I feel like our generation saw so much divorce that now they're just like, do you know what? I'll just do it on my own. That's what I, like, when I picture a family, I'm like, I won't have a kid until I can have it on my own. Right. And when I can raise a kid by myself, then I will bring another person into it.
And there's plenty of children out there that need loving homes to 100%. Go to, by the way, whether they're yours or whether they're adopted. All right, I got this question in so many different emails, and we got it from the chat room. What reality show would you want to be on next? Like, what kind of reality show, or if there's a reality show out there that you would love to be on? Mine is Real Housewives of New York City. Jay, you go first.
Jay.
Because this would be your third reality show in your career.
I would love to mix it all up, the love and the competition, and I would love to be on The Challenge. Yeah. Hands down, it is, because they have Paula Dicking, so they say on The Challenge.
Who what?
And Paula Dicking.
Is which, that a person? Or is
which
that
means
a,
they hook up with people to, like, stay with it? People to further their alliance in order to win the game. But there's also challenges, and there is also a lot of drama and strategy play, and it's literally both of the shows that I've done mixed together, and I'm so down for that, and I'm waiting to compete, so give me a call.
Yeah. And like I said, all the physical challenges, you were just like, okay.
Oh, I would love it, dude.
Yeah.
I would go to town.
All right.
I'm just seeing my fans.
Me? Honestly, I really want to go on X on the Beach. Like, I mean, I haven't had a lot of, like,
Kendall would show up and, like, a nun, and we'd be like, you got some explaining to do.
About what?
Like, your ex is, like, the joke is, it's he's a saying, nun because, like, you're don't so have faithful. Any. Yeah.
No, I mean, I tell my ex, I'm like, I'm the best ex-boyfriend you ever could. Like, shit, like, when we were dating and, like, now where we're at, like, damn. Honestly, I want to get on that. Like, I played the nice guy. I played very quiet, ready. I'm ready to go mix things up. I mean, I want to go on and, like find the whole thing that's trying to work and be like, no, like, forget this guy. Like, look at me. Let's go. You know,
I don't know if you could handle it. Do you guys think that he could handle the ex on the beach environment.
Based on what?
Is he a single or is he an ex?
None of my exes would be on that show. That's serious. One of my exes is married. Keep in mind, she's 21.
Well, clearly she can't be on it.
No. The next one is like
I tried
Die
that.
Hard. No, my exes would not be on that show.
Well, you need an ex to be on the show of Ex on the Beach.
Wouldn't you be on? Can't you come on as a single or like?
No.
Yeah, but you need at least
need exes
one ex
to show up.
I could make an ex-girlfriend.
So it'd be Kendall.
You could make an ex-girlfriend. Why don't you start like giving feelings to a girl now so that when they ask you,
practice
would you
being
want to be on the show,
dad.
Be like, I just broke up with some bitch. How about that?
I mean, I'm single now. I was in something.
Well, I mean, you already have an ex because Kendall is kind of like a moment with you.
Yeah, but I mean, I haven't seen her in like 3 weeks, really.
3 weeks?
Okay. Like, she's gone. Like, she's gone. Hey, girl.
She's long
like,
gone. 3 weeks?
I'm like, you guys know it's just coming out. He was like, oh, yeah, Kendall and I do Taco Tuesdays and we feed the poor every other week.
The
and
truth
now,
is coming.
Now no, she's no, left no, for
no.
years.
No, no, it's, I mean, we just.
I don't think Kendall was the best for you, by the way.
Who do you think on the show would have been best for me?
Because she, on the show, nobody.
Yeah, facts.
So I lose either way.
Nobody. Because
so I go home.
You come to the table with a lot of, like, you're a gentleman, and you have all that, but you also have this new energy, and you're adventurous.
Yeah.
So you need...
I'm ready to learn.
Yeah.
I need
so
someone
you need to a, you need a girl.
Who do you think? Who
Daniel
do you think
Stott from Real Housewives of New Jersey. That's who.
How old is she?
Hold on. David.
16, 12.
What about Morgan? Didn't you slide in her DMs?
Oh! I did slide in Morgan's DMs. I got
the shade.
Are you guys? Are you kidding me?
I
we talked about it on the car ride over.
Are we going to be on X on the Beach 5 together?
Maybe. I
the joke would be you
no,
guys
listen,
would end
listen,
up together.
Listen. I sent her like the I sent
like
her,
me and Corey.
I did. I sent her a video of me twerking.
No, you fucking didn't.
I did. I am serious. She posted something about like, this is what I do on my leg day with my booty bands, and I was like, well, this
you
is
literally
how I
messaged
am.
His ex girlfriend.
Yeah.
Yeah, and now so, we're going to have our drinks after this.
Okay,
how about that?
And instead of a preacher man,
we're building the team, Morgan.
All right, real fast.
Remember,
strength in numbers.
Real fast. It's last call. We're gonna take a quick peek. So we've seen Jay be the gentleman and the fun guy, and he's family loving. Take a peek at X on the Beach when he wasn't so.
Okay,
so
when I got dropped on my ass because of Kareem.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Jay versus Corey.
Look at Corey, dude.
Yours me. No,
he's soft. Go for him.
He's just like,
oh, I
can take him.
Oh, he's got it.
Oh! Why did that guy get in the way?
Because that's Korean. He's my boy.
Jay is props, man. Fighting for his love. Man, you go fight for your love, boy.
But he stopped
you. Go get your girl.
No, I don't see anything under 6 foot under...
Oh.
What did he just say?
He said, I don't see anything under 6 foot.
So he's going to see
you. He sounds like an ex-college baseball guy. I would say the same thing.
He's just from Texas.
You guys, I had pages and pages of more notes, but we have to end the show. So we're doing rapid fire for you all.
Yes.
Who wants to go first?
Murray.
You didn't get
Murray.
The answer last time.
If you don't have a drink, take a swig now.
2-on-1. You have to finish the cups. Oh, Murray. Look at your cup,
I
dude.
Just got a refill.
Yeah, good.
Yeah.
We're just looking at the wall.
Oh, yeah. You didn't even ask me my last question, first of all. And then show that I would want to be on.
Oh, yes. What show would you want to
be on? Is a mixture of, like, I like the challenge. I like something that you can be a repeat person on because people get to see more of your personality. And I don't like being on, like, one season they chop you up wherever. So, like,
the
being
though?
On something that you have, like, a moment. The challenge is great because I think it's
would you really be on the challenge?
I would rather be on Beverly Hills Housewives. Talk about that.
Okay, so that's it.
That's a show that you'd rather be on.
I would rather be on Housewives.
And I think Bravo is ready for the first gay housewife, no matter what city it is.
Yes, girl.
That'd be good.
Hey, can we, somebody watching this, can we start that? How about that?
Hashtag Murray on, what is it? Beverly Hills?
Housewives of Beverly Hills.
Housewives of Beverly Hills?
No, I think West Hollywood needs its own.
The Queens of.
Yes.
The Queens of West Hollywood.
Ooh. That's not the best name, but we're.
I'm trying.
It.
I'm trying to help you.
No, he's being an ally.
I'm trying to help you, dude. You said the challenge.
I love when straight men go.
No, but
girl.
I like the challenge because I like.
No. This is this thing because since I've known him on X on the Beach, so he's been like, "Hey, girl." When I wake up, I'm like, "What's up, bitch?" Like, look, that's just the thing.
That's
we do.
Awesome. That's great.
I love him.
I would like, "Hey, girl," right down the stairs with the fan. And
oh
like,
my
click,
god!
Click, click, wake up, bitch. How about it?
Click, click.
All right, Bravo. And I will have you know, Bravo watches the show. So,
oh, cute.
Mm-hmm. Cute.
Hey, Bravo, my friend Murray wants to be on, please.
But I would love to see a West Hollywood show where we're all represented because, like, we're in the same circle, but we're so different and, like, we don't really run into each other.
Right.
So I would love to see West Hollywood as to like the full community, because it's a lot of different things.
But you could also reach into any city that you want, and just because we gays around the world. How about that?
How about not just gays?
New York, LA, Miami, like get a whole array of people. Hmm. Whatever.
Cool.
Okay, rapid fire. Let's do it.
Okay, you first?
Yeah. Mom. No, yes. Jay first.
No, you first.
I'm gonna go two on one. Girl, I did go.
Jay, I actually think that you're the best person to go first.
All right, fine.
You have to go back to Survivor with no help. You have to take an actor, a singer, and an athlete. Who are you taking?
An actor, Brad Pitt.
Oh, yeah, God.
Same. A singer, Celine Dion.
Ooh.
What is she going to do on the island?
Everyone's going to be so infatuated with her, they won't even think of me.
Wow.
She's going to sing to you the whole time. You just sit there and listen. And enjoy your
they won't
vacation.
Even think of me. I could just chill.
I think she'd die in 20 minutes.
That's fine. Okay. It's not my problem.
And an athlete.
Tiger Woods.
Is he an athlete?
I'm
yes.
just kidding. Ah!
Yes.
He's a cheater.
Just kidding.
Do you want to? No, no. This is why. I need two good people and one bad guy. All shields. I'm safe.
Did we get this? Okay. Send it to TMZ. Okay.
No, that's sorry, but sorry,
Celine
Tiger.
Dion, I'm talking about in order to survive. Yeah, Celine Dion would be like, right, the fire.
Oh,
is
to survive?
Yes.
Bear Grylls, myself, and, well, he died. What was the crocodile hunter's name? Steve Irwin.
Yeah, so maybe survival wasn't his best thing.
Oh,
God.
Wow.
God, I hope we can edit that. Jay, worst thing you said or did on TV you wish they hadn't filmed?
When I spit up all the vodka.
Okay.
That was funny, though. So I'm kind of happy to do it.
First thing you notice about a girl, and be honest, don't be like her spirit.
No, their face.
But like what aspect?
Their whole face. And their teeth. Their teeth.
He loves a pretty.
So teeth.
Yeah.
Teeth first.
Yeah,
teeth. And you've mentioned teeth
but
a few
face,
times.
But face and teeth. It's got to be both. It's like all face.
I want them to have a butt
Murray
face
knows.
And great
I've
teeth.
Only seen it with pretty, pretty blonde girls.
What's the blonde?
No, not just blonde.
Well, it started with Morgan, and that's how it like... stereotype guy.
Yeah.
Morgan, please respond stung. To me.
Morgan, respond to the man.
You guys, I really,
he's thirsty.
What a small, that
imagine
is so
me group,
funny.
Okay,
group
okay, okay. Him and Morgan.
Oh,
together later.
Should we do it now?
Hey, Morgan, Dave, I just
do it. Do it.
You have
stay
to,
loco.
You have to cast yourself as one of the Avengers. Which one is it? This actually came from one of your fans.
Ooh, Thor.
Mm. The fat Thor, or like the rip Thor.
Big girls need love too.
I'm sure
Santa
you're
Barta.
6%. Show your abs again. Let's show some. Let's have an ab off.
Stop. Is the question, guy.
We got about 45 emails about his twerking. By the way,
I'd be middle Thor.
Why are we talking about that?
Middle Thor.
Because then he gets to chill and kick it, and then also like save.
And he gets to make out with Natalie Portman.
Me too.
Worst way you've broken up with somebody?
Over text.
Dude, are you that guy that I've done it to, but?
Yeah, but then I ended up going to her house and telling her, like, yeah, we're done for real.
And then you were like, one last time.
I played the bit.
Ah! Okay, Jay, tell our viewers and listeners where they can find you, social media, everything.
Oh, man. So find me at JQSKIM on Instagram, J_QS on Twitter, JStarrett on YouTube, stay loco, JStarrett.com. That leads you to everything. Just go to JStarrett.com and it'll take you to Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, all of it, all of the above. Thank you.
What a joy to have you here. Like, finally getting to meet you, and you're so chill.
Oh, I appreciate that.
Like,
dude.
I thought
thank
you were going to be chill, and then you were chill. I'm like, I love this.
Damn
job.
It. I didn't live up to the higher standard.
Who's next?
I'll go.
David Barta.
Yes.
Least favorite gym exercise? That you may have skipped a few times.
I have skipped a few times.
Oh, cock God. Push-ups.
That, like, that machine where you, like, it's like the glute machine. Like where like
the one that you squeeze like this?
That's a good girl, bad girl.
Or the one you, like,
I'm talking about like
girl,
the
up in there, like,
the
yeah,
leg extender.
Yeah, the like kickback one. Yeah, I just I don't know. Fuck that.
Like, it looks like you do it. You were starting a new baseball team for reality TV. What's the name of the team and what's the mascot?
Dildos.
Sorry. Wow,
that's
girl.
Wait. Because we were talking about it vibrators, and now you went to...
His
I'm wondering about...
The
Sherman,
freaks.
I wonder about these straight
how about
boys.
That?
That
how about that? The freaks.
The freaks.
Yeah.
And what's the mascot?
Condom.
Murray.
Oh my God, I'm totally going to be your
Murray's
mascot.
Murray's the
mascot.
I could actually
mascot.
See that.
You're
it would
so
have these eyebrows
right
and this
it.
Jawline and
the
this
freaks.
Hair. Like, I could totally see that.
And no clothes, just angles.
Yeah, exactly.
Angles.
Just angles and hiding all the D. Like, not here, not there. Somewhere.
Surprise.
You're stuck at Paradise Hotel.
Yes. Oh boy.
The room with celebrity. Who's it with?
Morgan.
I said celebrity. Yes, I
said
that.
Shit. No, I think Morgan's beautiful. I mean,
I said celebrity.
Dang.
She is hot.
She is hot.
Super hot.
Like, Morgan, come on. Person, she's like, what other white boy pastors can move their ass like
that? How about somebody that can pay the rent? Does that narrow it down?
Someone who can pay. Oh, Kendall Jenner.
Oh,
no.
My.
I said celebrity. You guys, I'm just.
Well,
teasing.
If I had to pick someone who wasn't Morgan, it'd be.
A celebrity means somebody that's
Kendall,
on TV
Kendall
and
Jenner.
Film.
Is that not. That's not TV and film.
No, but Kendall Jenner is a celebrity.
She's a celebrity.
I like her. Yeah. I feel like she likes.
She's a billionaire, good choice.
She could, like. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I think you guys have a lot in common.
I feel like she could use a good time out of me. Like,
yeah, she prays.
Like I'm a fun. Does she? You know what's the best part about going to Catholic school? Catholic school. Never mind. Anyways, next question.
Yes. Worst date you've ever had?
Oh God, it wasn't even supposed to be a date.
It wasn't.
What?
It wasn't like I didn't dress up. I was super casual. She came out in dress. And I was like, "Fuck, this is terrible." We're supposed to go see a movie. We're like, "Oh, we should."
What movie? Movies are the worst dates. Don't ever go on a date.
I don't even remember. I think Slender Man, which was like the weirdest movie.
That is so weird. Unless she was like a goth girl.
Did she choose that? You know Morgan likes horror films.
Wow, you're just like.
Well, she dated a few horror films in her life.
Yikes.
Hey, excuse me, I'm Prince Charming. What's up?
Single. I love this guy.
By choice.
I love this guy. Hey. So Slender Man.
Yeah, it was just awkward. And I had my arm around her, and just kept getting weirder. And I was like, "I'm sorry."
How casual did you dress? Like gym shorts and a
tight. I don't think
that
matters.
Like baseball hat. Like
that's sexy.
She came
though.
In a dress. She came in a dress. He said
to go to the movies though. Who wears a dress to the movies?
Like baseball.
She was
hat
trying
like
too hard. She
should
have been
shirt.
Like, "It's a movie date. Let me dress like I would dress when I go to the movies."
Exactly.
Okay. Mm. Yeah. Okay. We'll do a date and we'll see. What is your?
I don't know about that.
Are you going to wear a suit?
Always. Oh, Murray, you saw me at the pool party. I was in a suit.
He really was.
I know. He's
was
known
too
for wearing
hot.
A suit.
I was barely even able to wear a Speedo. Like, I was, like, sweating my off.
I didn't know he was Jewish until
will
I saw
him at
the
pool party. Will you wear a suit shirt?
Off. Okay.
And he's in a full
does
suit.
Does that count?
Like, boop, 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 boop,
boop. Yeah, I actually sang that, too. Oh, David.
Yes.
Since you're so into fitness, but what is your unhealthiest habit?
In what realm? Like eating
any
realm. Or like...
Like in the health
not eating,
realm.
Like
I'll eat a tub of fries or...
Or like...
I love chocolate. I mean, take that how you want it, but I love chocolate.
Take that how we want it? What does that mean?
All of a sudden, Sherman's
I mean,
very busy
there's
on
different
this
types of chocolate. Right. I mean, like brownies or like...
Chocolate women.
That's what I got from it.
That's what I got.
Next question.
That was
oh,
it.
Oh, okay.
So your unhealthiest habit is, but like, do you binge eat chocolate?
Oh,
a lot of fitness people are like, oh, I love pizza. And they'll have like the little tip and like
oh,
one pepperoni,
God.
Like, oh, I'm done. Like,
no, like,
when you eat chocolate, do
you like
you eat like, chocolate?
Yeah. Like,
okay.
if
we were to have like a movie night and we were just going to like,
if
throw
you guys
down,
bring a chocolate cake, fuck, like, I got it.
Would you eat the whole cake?
I got it. Like, please don't bother me. Like, just let me, like,
the whole cake.
Yeah.
Perfect. David Barta, where can our viewers and listeners find you?
So I'm at Instagram at the Real D Bar, Twitter David Barta, Facebook David Barta, DavidBarta.com, and then I have my fitness link there for personal training, such like that. And I'm in Burbank. So
I was up with you till the very end. Burbank.
So set your hinges to Burbank because
exactly.
David Barta
5 mile
will
radius
be waiting.
Set your Tinder to Burbank. How about that?
Hinge?
I don't have any dating.
How about you set anything to Burbank? It's the armpit
of life. You don't know what Hinge
life.
Is? No. It's like Grindr, but better.
What? All
Hinge.
Of a sudden, what?
Hinge.
Is Hinge better than Grindr?
I don't have any dating apps. Is that
well, I don't know. That's, I don't fuck with Grindr, but like, yeah.
What,
Hinge is the best for straight dudes.
Oh, straight. Oh, yeah.
I don't play
better than Tinder?
By far.
Well, I didn't know. Calm down,
okay.
Jay Starrett.
Let's plug.
No,
that.
I found this out like 5 months ago.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
All right,
and
everybody.
It's been doing great for you.
Shut up! Wait, I don't
what?
Fuck with Hinge.
Okay, my turn. Go ahead. What are you going to cancel the show? Like, what's going on? You're just about to give that.
Oh yes! Oh God. Where did he go?
He had to go. PWE.
This is probably what happened when he lost his virginity.
He got voted off.
10 minutes out, and then he's running out of the room.
He saw a vibrator.
Shiny.
Oh my God, what is that? Kurt, what's that
I'm
noise?
So sorry. Okay. Kurt, okay. Kurt is like, we finally have straight people and it's still a mess. Okay, Murray, what sorry, body part, this is actually from the chat room. What, not the chat room, emails. What body part on yourself would you change?
Would I change?
And I'm saying you don't have to change anything, but this was...
I would definitely say my ass because I really like a perfect bubble butt. Like
it has to be a C. Beginning, middle,
really,
and end.
I'm really, really attracted to that. I don't know, whatever. So I'm like, I wish I had that.
Well, Nick has a good C.
No, he has a great ass, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
For sure, which is why I'm attracted to that.
Oh.
How about that?
Okay. You have that? To spend 3 days... Oh, God. Okay. Just answer on. The question.
Let me have a drink of bubble.
You have to spend 3 days with your ex, Corey Z. Where would you go and what would you be doing for 3 days and you have to spend every single minute with him?
Okay, who is asking these questions?
I did. Sorry.
Oh, thank you. Okay, 3 days with Corey Z. I couldn't leave his side. That.
Where would you be going?
It would be a tropical destination. No, he gets so mad about that. He's just like, he doesn't like a lot of things. He just likes to stay at home and like sit in the hotel and do nothing. So I guess we could be anywhere because I would just be out and about like being a tourist, and he would just be in the hotel room doing nothing. So let's say, oh, actually, do you know what? He went to Brazil and went out of the hotel a couple times. I'd go to Brazil because he like left the hotel.
And what would you be doing?
I'd be partying with all the hot Latin boys.
Okay.
Portuguese.
Oh, Portuguese men.
I'm Peruvian.
They'll ruin your credit, but they'll make your life amazing.
I've dated Brazil.
Least favorite. And you're Peruvian, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
Girl, I do like research.
Puedo hablar español, pues.
Yeah, but Peruvian Spanish is very different. And you guys have secret, like when we're all speaking Spanish, Peruvians do like little secret jokes.
Oh my God, thank
and I'm like,
you.
I speak Spanish you. Too. Oh, no, I don't. You know what I'm talking
well,
about.
Well, all cultures have their own things.
Yes.
Like Mexicans are always like, oh, orla la way. And
they're
like, no
Mexicans
one says
like,
that.
Oh, we have a cow here because some people didn't know that cows exist in Mexico.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, well, least favorite grooming regimen.
Not very well traveled.
Least favorite grooming regimen.
His eyebrows.
Pubes.
His
love,
eyebrows are actually
love
amazing,
my eyebrows.
By the way.
I know.
Love
that's why it's his least favorite. He has to make them perfect.
Area down there. It's doing great.
Sure.
We
have
I would
Instagram,
say,
dude. We have Instagram.
Do you know what? I actually
smooth
don't.
Guys have it so easy. Like, I'm like the wolfman after 3 days.
Well, I'm already going to get laser hair remove on my butt, but I love a perfectly smooth ass. And I don't like having
past.
To deal with it. So like okay. You get laser hair removal 7 times and it's done forever. That's what I like.
Okay.
Nobody likes a
worst pickup line that
a forest, bitch. How about that?
How about that?
Into the woods. Worst pickup line you've ever heard.
Worst pickup line I've ever heard. I've had I don't know.
It's what rapid fire, girl.
Most people don't even start with the pickup line. They just say something stupid.
Okay,
like,
so
what
Jay what's
said to you in the car?
What?
What Jay said to you in the car?
I'm really
what?
Upset, what? By the what? Way, Sherman. What? I'm not part of this car thing.
We are
like
really...
The
okay,
thanks.
Everybody knows I'm really bad at rapid
I'll give you
fire
a pickup
because
line.
I talk too much. Okay, give me a pickup line. How about
right
that?
Right now, go.
Rapid
fire. Be local.
You should own a hot dog stand because you sure know how to make a wiener stand.
Yeah. Oh, I like that one, actually. You win for the best one, actually. That's probably the best one I've had.
Oh! The pun master! I'm fucking winning.
Good yeah, job, you're in guy. Good company.
Shut up. You love me. Get
They're
over
usually
it.
Like...
Smile if you love me. Get over it.
Yeah, okay, weird. Kiss, marry, kill. Ross Matthews, Perez Hilton, James Corden.
I didn't get that.
Wait, repeat the names.
We're talking gay talk. Kiss, marry, kill. Ross Matthews, Perez Hilton, James Corden.
I don't even know who two of those people are.
Who?
Ross Matthews or James...
Ross Matthews' friends.
You know who Ross Matthews is? From RuPaul's Drag Race?
Oh, I do know who he is. Oh, yeah, yeah. He does a drag
Ross
show.
Ross
okay, yeah, okay, what's the third one?
James Corden.
Yeah, who's that?
James Corden, he sings in the
Emmy
car.
Nomination? No, he has the biggest.
Yeah, he sings in the cars.
Late night TV show.
He sings in the cars with all the artists.
Okay, well, I don't know. I don't know who it is, but I'm definitely gonna.
The
kill
dude with like,
because
he's
here.
Not like redhead, but he's also like blonde red.
And I will marry.
Jake, can we just hang out? Because you're more into him with like.
Yeah, you. Whatever.
Okay.
He sings. I'll marry the singer, and I'll.
He doesn't really sing. He's
no.
just alive.
He's just
he's like
the top-rated evening
head.
Show.
Could you pick three different people? How about that?
Okay, Corey Z, Pablo Hernandez.
No, you already did that last time I was here.
Or J Star. I know that.
Oh, I wasn't in the mix last time.
I'm
going
to marry Jay for sure.
You're not going to fuck me forever?
I'm going to do both.
Oh, okay, okay. Anyway, thank you, everybody. I really appreciate it. Kurt,
God.
Thank you for dealing with our shenanigans.
Hold on, Kurt.
Kurt, can we give a hand to Kurt?
Kurt!
We're not worthy. We're not worthy. I can't yell in the room.
I have to tell you, Kurt and his wife are so cute, and he's here for all this. A big thank you for our guest today, my guest co-host, Marie Swanby.
The best.
Kurt, Mama Rose, Here TV, and you, our loyal listeners. Real fast, guess who we have coming up? We have Broadway's Ariel in Little Mermaid, Christine in Phantom of the Opera, and appearing at Hollywood Bowl as Cinderella's Prince. We have Olivier nominated. Sierra Boggess is here next week. We have Margaret Cho coming. We have American Idol's Effie Passero. Will and Grace, who was also in Special, actor Brian Jordan Alvarez. Big Brother's Corey Brooks is coming back.
When? Can I come back to that show?
Man, I want to see this guy.
What the fuck?
America's Got Talent, Michael Paul. And I'm really excited about this. We have 8-time Academy Award nominee makeup artist V. Neil, who worked on Hunger Games, Beetlejuice, Mrs. Doubtfire, Pirates of the Caribbean, Edward Scissorhands, Days... Oh, yes. So that's what she worked on.
Edward Scissorhands.
Yeah, she did the makeup for all that. Oh. She's an 8-time Academy Award nominee. We're doing a whole thing about makeup. We also have Days of Our Lives, soap opera actor Jason Cook, and then Star Trek's Rod Roddenberry, and more. On the Rocks is the place to be every Tuesday. You guys, give a wave to your camera. Oh. Kurt, thank you so much.
This has been On the Rocks with Alexander every Tuesday at 7 p.m. on Universal Broadcasting Network. Find me on Facebook on the Rocks Radio Show. Tweet me or Instagram me at On the Rocks On Air. See you next Tuesday.